Hi guys, how are you? How's your dieting going on? So I'm helping you with this week update by showing you how to make pizza with broccoli crust. So it's obvious that we are making a crust from broccoli, so we have to take broccoli and I grate this amount of broccoli after washing it properly with the warm water. And the other ingredients are this is paneer, or this is called cheese. It's available in market also, and you can make the same in your home also. And I'm putting down the link below if you want to know how to make cheese at home. And this is the mozzarella cheese. This is the regular organic mozzarella cheese. It's a very good source of fat, and it will act as a very good binder in making pizza. So these are some material, and this is the psyllium husk, and I'm taking 2 spoons of psyllium husk to just act as a binder and a good source of fiber also. And these are our toppings: white onion, chopped white onion, and some capsicum tomatoes, or you can use as many toppings as you want. And these are some spices. I'm taking the red paprika, this is the garlic salt, and this is the pink salt, and the basic Italian seasoning. I'm going to take this. Black pepper will not go very well with broccoli, so I am not using black pepper. If you want to use black pepper, you can use it. So friends, the next step, we all know, we have to mix all the main ingredients into a bowl with the psyllium husk. So I'm going to mix broccoli, cheese, paneer, and psyllium husk in a bowl with little bit of pink salt. So friends, the good thing about this pizza, I'm going to make this on tawa, because in my comments, so many friends, they tell me that they don't have oven, so can you make it easy for them also? So I'm using my normal hot plate or tawa, you can say, and I'm putting all these ingredients. This is broccoli, and I'm making paneer and psyllium husk. I'm adding a little bit of salt and mix it properly. I'm going to use my hand. It's better to use your hand so that they mix and bind very well. I'm using little bit of cheese also. And the only thing you want to see that is your dough kind of broccoli, but broccoli is good enough for making crust. You can just make a roll out of it, and then you can see now it will roll properly to make a crust. So I'm going to flatten up this mixture to make a crust on the butter paper. As you can see, it bind very well. See, so it's very easy to make a crust. So next step is place a butter paper so that it will not stick or and come out very easily. So place your mixture on the butter paper and press down it with using both of your hands. So I'm now going to make it even by using a roller. make the edges even. And side by side heat your pan with little oiling over it. So guys, our pizza crust is ready. And I'm going to transfer this on the pan. You can see it's a very good pizza base. So grease your pan little bit and transfer this crust over the pan. So I'm going to transfer this on my pan. So guys, no worries if you find some cracks in there. So you have, because it's in still in soft state, so you can fill it by your finger or by some knife. So the next step, as we all know, that we are going to put pasta sauce over it and our other seasoning. So it's better just to make it little cooked over the one side. Since because we are making this pizza in our tawa or this hot plate, so we need to cook it both sides. So when one side will be done, then I'll flip it over other side and then I'm going to put my pasta sauce and other seasoning. So friends, just about 5 minutes I flipped it over to the other side and it's so elastic. If you want a crunchy pizza, then I advise you to make this crust on a low flame so that it will become crunchy little bit. Because of the cheese and paneer in to the batter, it's little cheesy kind of. So I'm doing my next step and I'm going to add pasta seasoning over it. This is also a homemade pasta seasoning, or you can use the seasoning available in the market. If you are making it at home, you can manipulate with the ingredients because you are on diet. So my next step, I'm going to put cheese over it. The flame is low, dear. I'm going to add my onion over it. You can choose any topping you want, olive, jalapeno. Now it's time for seasoning. So garlic salt. Little paprika. I prefer red paprika. The Italian seasoning. A little bit of salt over it. If you want to add tomato ketchup, you can also add over the layer of the pasta sauce. So because I'm restricting more sweet flavor, so I'm not using that. And now you can cover this pizza pan with your glass lid so that you can see the cheese melted down or not. So cook this pizza for about 5 to 8 minutes on the low heat until the cheese melts properly. Yeah, it looks so filling and too so tempting also. So we have to wait for another 5 minutes. Guys, I think my pizza is ready, so let's see. Oh my god, so tempting. I'm going to, and you can see the bread, so crunchy. Wow. So friends, enjoy your tempting yummy pizza and eat as much as you can. It looks so tasty and the aroma is so delicious. So friends, I'm going to tell you that the crust is very crunchy, though it's very soft. So you need you need the help of a little cutter to just remove from the pan. So I'm going to show you that the pizza is so tasty. So enjoy.